Welcome to iLecture Online. A number of viewers have asked us to continue with the Hamiltonian and Lagrangian equation, some more examples, so we thought, well, let's try to do a few more. So here we're going to start with item number 4 on the Hamiltonian equation set. Now, I figured let's go back and take another closer look at the Hamiltonian. So we're going to take a look at the Hamiltonian in a little bit more detail, the equation, where it comes from, why it works the way it does, compare it to the Lagrangian equation. It turns out solving mechanical problems is easier with the Lagrangian equation, but it's worth it to also take a look at the Hamiltonian. So the Hamiltonian equation is defined as the sum of the products of the, well, Q sub I. Well, what's Q sub I? Q is a random or general coordinate. For example, x, y, z, r, theta, and so forth could all be considered Q. So we have a randomized or a general position variable, and then we take the time derivative. Q dot is the time derivative of the position variable, which turns it into the velocity into that direction. And then we multiply that times the momentum, m times v, or m times q dot, so to speak. So you sum up all the various directions where you have the product of the position vector, time derivative of the position vector times the momentum, and then you subtract the Lagrangian equation from that. Remember, the Lagrangian is the difference between the kinetic and the potential energy. Essentially, I like this form better because it just reads easier. So the Lagrangian is the kinetic energy minus the potential energy of the particular problem we're dealing with. So how do we make sense out of that? Well, first of all, remember that the momentum is the mass times velocity, or m times q dot. So again, if we're dealing in general coordinates, then each time we have a coordinate here, this is the momentum in the same direction as that coordinate. So for familiarity, let's replace q by x. Again, x can be the general coordinate, so it's the sum of the x dot times p over all the coordinates, over all the directions, minus the Lagrangian equation. And then, to make it even easier to take a look at it, let's go ahead and just consider this equation for a single variable, the x direction. So we no longer have to sum it because we only have one of those products, because we're only dealing with one dimension now. Of course, you can see that you can add an infinite number, well, not quite infinite, of course, but many dimensions for a more complicated problem. So here we have x dot p. Now remember, x dot, it's the x coordinate taking the derivative of that with respect to time, which turns that into velocity. So essentially, this is like velocity times momentum. And remember that the Lagrangian is the kinetic energy minus the potential energy, so we're going to subtract that from this product. So we turn x dot into velocity, because that's easier to deal with, and momentum, we turn that into m times v. Again, that's what we're familiar with. Then, of course, when you multiply these two, you get m times v squared. But so we can compared to kinetic energy, we're going to multiply by 2 and divide by 2, so then you can see that we have twice 1/2 mv squared when we take that product, the velocity times the momentum. Then if we subtract the kinetic energy minus the potential energy, notice we get twice the kinetic energy here, because 1/2 mv squared is the kinetic energy in the x direction for this particular example. Subtract from that the kinetic energy, and minus times a minus means we're going to add the potential energy of the problem. So twice the kinetic energy minus kinetic energy gives you kinetic energy plus the potential energy, and that would then be the equation equivalent to the Hamiltonian. You can also write it like this. If you remember that T is the kinetic energy and V is the potential energy, the Hamiltonian is simply equal to the kinetic energy plus the potential energy. So essentially, the Hamiltonian is the total energy of the particle or the system or whatever it is that we're looking at. And of course, this is just in one dimension, but you can then realize that you can simply keep adding every dimension at the end and subtract the Lagrangian, and then you'll have the equation again, the total kinetic energy and the total potential energy of the problem as defined by the Hamiltonian. And that's where that equation came from.